Hello everyone, myself Ashok Sharma and I welcome you all on this channel. In this today's video, we are going to discuss question number 7 of exercise 7.1 of chapter number 7, that is triangles of class 9th maths. Before starting the discussion, I would like to request all my respected viewers, please subscribe the channel so that you may get all my maths videos directly to your device. Okay, and now today's question. Let us understand what is the meaning of the statement, what is given to us and what is to be obtained by us. Okay, let us check. The statement is AB is a line segment, this is AB. Okay, and P is its midpoint, this is P. P is the midpoint of AB means this AP and this PB, they are equal to each other because P is the midpoint. Next one. D and E are the points on the same side of AB. This is D, this is E. They are the points on the same upper side of this segment AB. Next one, such that angle BAD equals to angle ABE. Angle BAD at point A equals to angle ABE. Ye hamare paas ban gaya given. Next one, angle EPA equals to angle DPB. EPA this one, angle DPB this one, they are also equal to each other. Next one, what we have to show, triangle DAP, triangle EBP, they are equal. Triangle DAP, triangle EBP, they are equal. It is to be proved, as well as AD equals to BE. AD and BE, they are the corresponding sides of these two triangles. If we can prove that triangles congruent to each other, then automatically by CPCT we would write down AD and BE are equal to each other. So let us first draw triangle DAP and triangle EBP separately so that it becomes easier to understand this question. DAP, triangle number 1, this is triangle DAP. Second one, triangle EBP, this is triangle number 2, this one, triangle E, and this is B, this is B. So these are the two triangles which we have to show congruent to each other. Let us first check which points we already have in these two triangles. Suppose this is angle 1, this is angle number 2, and suppose this is angle 3 and 4 and 5. This is angle 1, this is angle number 5. AP and PB, they are equal. So now, in the given, what we have to write down, almost same statement is to be copied. You can say AB is a line segment, P is the midpoint, that is AP equals to PB, it is given to us. Next one, angle, which one? Angle BAD means we can say angle 1 equals to angle 5 using the numbers, as well as angle 2 equals to angle number 4, they are equal. It can be written in the given. Then after, to prove, it is given directly, so write down part first, triangle DAP congruent to triangle EBP first. Second one, triangle side AD equals to side BE. So given means AP and PB are equal because P is the midpoint of segment AB. Also, angle 1 equals to angle number 5, it is given. Also, angle 2 and 4 are equal, it is also given. So this is all about the given. To prove, same, triangle DAP equals to triangle ABP and AD equals to BE. Again, no need to do any type of construction. So we have to move to the proof directly. Proof. And now in these individual, or we can say separate figures, we can observe angle 1 and angle 5, they are equal, it is given. AP and PB, they are equal because P was the midpoint. So two points are already we have, you can say. Only third point, this one, this angle and this complete angle, if we can prove these two angles equal to each other, then by using side angle, side congruence criteria, we can prove them congruent to each other. Now, what is this angle? DPA. Angle DPA, it is the combination of the two numbers 2 and 3. That is, it is angle 2 plus angle 3. EPB. EPB, it is the combination of the two numbers 3 and 4. As already we can say, because angle 2 and angle 4, they are already equal to each other. As we have done in the previous video, in the previous question, you can say in question number 6. Because 2 and 4 are equal and we need angle 3 also along with these two. So adding angle 3 on both the sides, dekhi kya banta hai? Because angle 2 equals to angle number 4, it is given. Next one, adding angle number 3, angle 3 on both sides. If we add angle 3 on both sides, what it becomes? It becomes angle 2 plus angle 3 on the left hand side and angle 3 plus angle 4 on the right hand side. And if we use the name for these two, then what is the single name of angle 2 plus angle 3? We can see in the original figure, main figure, 2 plus 3 means angle DPA. So it can be replaced by angle DPA. Similarly, angle 3 plus 4, it can be replaced by EPB. So it is equal to angle EPB and give it result number 1. This was the only point you can say. This was the only result which we wanted to find out. It was not given in the statement. It is to be obtained by us. Okay. And now, in these two triangles, angle 1 equals to angle 5, already given. AP equals to PB, already given. And this angle we have obtained right now. Triangle angle DPA, it is equal to angle EPB. It can be taken from here. So now, in triangle, what is the name of the triangles? DAP, and the name of the second triangle is triangle EBP. In these two triangles, first result, angle 1 equals to angle 5 because it is already given in the statement of the question. Second one, side AP, that is base AP and base PB, they are equal. It is also given in the statement of the question. And the third and the last point is this one, angle DPA, it equals to angle EPB. Why? Because from one we can take this result. So angle DPA equals to angle EPB. So now, therefore, this implies we can write down triangle DAP is now congruent to triangle EBP by using which rule? Angle side angle. So write down here by angle side angle congruence criteria or angle side angle rule. And if these two triangles are congruent, then in part number 2 we can write down now this AD and BE, they are equal. Why? Because by CPCT, that is, this was part first and this is part second. AD and BE now equal because by CPCT, that is the corresponding parts of these two congruent triangles. So very small, or you can say very easy question. The only one point which we have to obtain ourselves. Otherwise, the remaining two points are already given in the statement of the question. So given is the same, to prove is the same. There is no constriction at all in the proof. This angle 2 and angle 4, they are already equal to each other. We have to add the middle angle, angle number 3, in both of these two. So 2 plus 3 equals to 3 plus 4, and thereafter the combined name of angle 2 plus 3 is angle DPA, and the combined name of angle 3 and 4 is angle EPB. So angle DPA equals to angle EPB, result number 1. and then after using this angle side angle congruence criteria we can prove that these two triangles are congruent to each other, and by CPCT the AD and BE, these two sides will also be equal. Okay, so I am sure all of you have understood this very well. We will meet in some next video with some next important question. Till then, do very much hard work and get more marks, higher marks. Okay, all the best.